Folks, we're going to take you on a trip all over New York as Bubba cruises in his big black Mercedes. Here I go.
Take me with you, Bubba. Take me with you.
Wouldn't want to see you.
Hi, this is Bubba, and here we are at the VideoMaker Expo. We're on the floor. We're getting ready to go and interview some people, and today we're going to talk to people about nonlinear editing and how they use computers with their video, home videos and with their wedding videos and all kinds of other applications. So let's go. We're going to go on inside now. Come on, guys.
Hold it, Bubba. I'm coming.
How are you doing with these bags that you're handing out for B&H video?
Every person that is coming in is willing to wait online to take a bag and a pamphlet.
So everybody's enjoying these bags? Do they think they're real good or what?
Yes. Instead of carrying all the bags, they put all their pamphlets, they put it in the bag.
Okay, this is video cameras. We've got more video cameras. Some of the video cameras are digital. That means that they don't store anything except in zeros and ones on the tape. Those tapes happen to be a lot smaller than the other tapes. Is that the same ladder that they used when they were making the Superman movies with Christopher Reeve?
That I don't know.
Okay. Bubba's back again, and now we're with the big gun, the big honchos, VideoMaker. We're with Steve Muratori, who is one of the kings of VideoMaker Magazine.
He's so weird.
That we're visiting here, and they know everything about where video is, has been, and will be. Steve, how are you doing today?
I'm fine, but I'm really just a pop gun, and I'm not a king, I'm a pawn. But I am the editor of the magazine, so you might as well ask me questions.
He's a star, you hear that? I'm going to get his autograph, and I'm going to show it to everybody back when I get back to Atlanta. Steve, we're real interested in where do you see computers fitting into video today?
It's really more where does video fit into computers today. That's kind of what's happening. For a long time in the past, video, the world of video was over here. It was Mars, and the world of computers was over there. It was Jupiter. They didn't, like, cross paths very much. And a lot of people that started out in video didn't know much about those guys over there in computers and vice versa. But now it's converging. You know, it's all really coming together, mostly from the point of view of the analog video signal that's always been analog waves is turning into digits, ones and zeros, so that you can put it on your hard drive on your computer and edit it right from there. So a lot of the excitement at this show and what's going on is people are talking about how to get that video signal digitized and how to use it once you import it into your computer.
And I'm speaking with Dennis Heathbrink, is that right?
Yeah, that's
from
right.
Adobe Systems Inc. And now this is a fellow that we were just talking to another fellow about, their Adobe Premiere software. And we're going to ask him a little bit about Adobe itself and how it works, and he's going to tell us a little bit about that. Now first though, I want to ask you, Dennis, how do you like being at the show?
It's okay. It's another day away from the office. So that's good.
Do you have to go home and kick the dog or anything after a day?
No, I just slap the kid around a little bit.
Can you tell us what nonlinear editing is?
Certainly. Nonlinear editing is an addition to traditional editing in that it allows you the ability to bring in video into a computer system, add special effects, do overlay of graphics, mix and match things,
I don't understand a word he's saying.
So do transitions, but do it in a computer environment, in a digital domain, rather than in traditional tape through a switcher.
Okay, now, what did you say in English? I know you used about 97,000 technical terms like switchers and digitize and all those things. Tell us in English, what does it do?
Well, it allows anybody with a computer and the proper amount of hardware to go out with a camera, shoot some footage of the family picnic, bring it home into your computer, and do your own editing and make your own movie and maybe be the next Spielberg.
Gee, that's pretty cool. I think everybody wants to be the next Spielberg, at least in their banker's mind. I look pretty cool. I got a picture of myself coming out now. Oh, yeah. Sitting here with John Koschel. John, tell me what you do.
I'm a professor of film in the Department of Theater and Film at Long Island University, CW Post Campus.
You said a mouthful there. John, what's your impression so far of the show?
I would like to say...
Enabling people to do things that heretofore were only really possible to be done by professionals in television studios, and there's a... So I have mixed opinions that, to some extent, I think it's great that people now on the home level can do this kind of film and video work or motion picture work at home. On the other hand, I'm looking at all of these like sort of Rube Goldberg slapped together kind of odd products that you know aren't going to be around in a couple of years.
So what do you think about the idea of giving everybody, even me, Bubba, the ability to go out there and do things that only the professionals could do before? I mean,
excellent. Excellent. A wonderful thing.
Now that just gives us the chance to completely screw up things and make terrible pictures and good
pictures.
Give
Bubba more power. More power to Bubba.
Oh yeah, it's great that everybody now can talk to one another through microphones and televisions, and we could all talk to more people. So in that respect, it's fantastic. Just as a way of all like caveat emptoring or, you know, buyer bewareing, I just look at a lot of the products seem, that they might be nice to have because you have this desire to communicate, but on the other hand, I'm thinking, boy, how long is this particular device going to be around? So I myself am in the market, you know, to see what I could buy to put in my school and program and for my home and for my kids, so...
Well, we're here. We're going to be looking at a couple other booths for John to get those home boxes that he wants to get. So we're going to be coming back to John in just a few minutes to get his reaction after he sees some of the other products that we're going to be looking at. I'm standing here with Devin Good from the Gold Disc Ink Company, and they make something called a Video Director, which is a low-cost editing system for you to use with your computer at home to edit your good old vacation tapes down to about 20 minutes, because you actually had 10 minutes of good footage and you shot 16 hours of videotape. So, Devin, what can you tell us about what you've got here?
Well, Video Director Home is the product we're demoing right here. The interface on the screen is fairly intuitive. Anybody that buys a camcorder typically takes far too much video.
Yeah, that's right. It sure do take too much video. Very intuitive.
Something that's entertaining. Get rid of the bad stuff and put the good stuff in the order you want and put it on a VHS tape. We give you a way to do that with Video Director. Basically, this is how the product works. It comes with what we call a smart cable. The smart cable plugs into the serial port on your computer. You get a 25-pin or you get a 9-pin adapter. You've also got a LANC jack. Most camcorders sold these days have what we call a LANC jack or a remote jack, control L. Hardwires right into the camcorder. If you don't have that, you might have infrared remote control capabilities on the computer or on the camcorder. So this is an infrared sensing device. This allows the computer to actually control the camcorder using infrared. This infrared sensing device also controls the VCR. Any wireless remote control VCR is going to work with Video Director Home. So that's how the computer is going to control the camcorder and the VCR.
Hey, does anybody here speak English?
Starts it and stops it where you want it to start and stop.
Absolutely. That's exactly what it does. You're going to be using your computer to either fast forward or rewind your camcorder to actually play your camcorder. While you're playing your camcorder, you'd be recording on the VCR. It's sending signals to both those pieces of equipment to do what you're telling it to do, basically.
Okay, here we are with the television studio in a suitcase. Now, it was in my suitcase. Look, he's putting it up here. This fella, he's a retired CIA man. We can't really state his name because there are a lot of governments looking for him right now.
All the cables, all your wires and connections are in the bag. That way you don't have to worry when you go on an airplane or a subway, taxis. In New York, you carry everything in the back seat with you. The suitcase is a truck. You now weigh video monitors, suitcases that you checked in as luggage. It'll carry 280 pounds. Next thing is it opens up. And it's got double locks. It's got a key lock and it's got a combo lock. It's a no-brainer. It comes with all kinds of little cushions and separators. We take them all out. We don't need them. It's carpeted inside here so we can stack all our things in here side by side.
What's going into memory is the name of the tape, the name of the clip, where it starts and where it stops. Not the video, just the information as to where the clip lies on the 8mm. So we say okay, and under My Vacation, well, we've created a same name, but there it is. Tower Jumpers number 2 from My Vacation, that's the clip. We've got a few other clips as well. So you get the idea, you go through that 8mm and pick all the ones that you like.
And then once you've got them all done, I guess you just press a single button and it goes through and it forwards one tape back and forth and does your whole edit for you, right?
Yeah, to a certain extent. I mean, what you've got is a library of different tapes, possibly. You got My Vacation with a bunch of clips. You've got other tapes with other clips. And we got Spring Break.
So it can actually have you change tapes and everything.
Absolutely.
Well, this looks like a great product, and I understand it's under $100.
It's under $50. It's $49.95, actually.
What a deal. Has anybody ever told you that you look and sound like Don Johnson?
No, nobody ever has.
Well, how's Melanie do it?
Well, you know, Melanie and I, we're on the outs, kind of.
It doesn't work anymore.
That's okay. There's a lot of fish in the sea.
Well, I want to thank you.
All right, Bubba,
Don.
Thank you.
He's really broken up, huh?
Here's some more sticks over here, and this is one of the brand new cameras that they've just come out with. This is one of the brand new cameras they've just come out with. It's called the Woody. And anybody that needs a Woody, come on over here and you can get yourself a Woody right here on this set of sticks. Now remember, sticks are a tripod. They're not real stick. And that's what they call them. That's what the pros call them. So come on down and get this Woody. This is a big time Woody. This is a big Woody for all you people that need a big Woody. And here we have the small Woody for all you people that want a small Woody.
It's happening now. It's not the future anymore. Digital video is here. It's here to stay. It's going to ultimately replace analog video, and everything's going to be digital eventually, which means you're going to be able to use your computers to edit video the way that you use them to edit words in a word processor today, very simply, very intuitively, very creatively.
Well, you think that's going to change the way we do word processing? Or in the future, are we going to send somebody a word processing file, or will we send them a digital file?
Absolutely. You'll probably be able to send them a multimedia file that might have words in it, and when you click on a certain window, you've got moving video in it, and you've got sound in it, and you might have other kinds of interactivity going on in it as well, so that video no longer will be exclusively the stuff that you see on your TV screen. It'll be a component of lots of different media. You'll get to used to reading newspapers that start to talk to you, things like that.
Well, do you think you said it's no longer going to be what you see on your TV screen. Do you think maybe that what we might see in the future is that the TV, the telephone, and the computer might only be one item in the future?
This is already starting to happen. The convergence is happening that way. We're from the television side, you're seeing television manufacturers build TV sets that have computers built in. They're already starting to market television sets, for example, that will surf the World Wide Web. So you could sit in your living room, turn on your TV, and do your web surfing, right? So a TV with a computer inside. On the other side, for a longer time, you've had computers that are importing TV signals. There are boards that are right here in this show. You slap it in your computer, turn on your computer, and there's a TV set inside. And so it's going both ways, and as well, you're talking about telephone answering machines, fax machines, all that will certainly be integrated into instruments that can do all of those things. Right now, the home PC can do all of those things right now, but also what you're going to see is the spreading out of the computer, like melting butter. It's going to kind of flow and spread all over things. So that you might not...
Oh, you put it on bread, too?
Yeah, you can put it on bread. Well, they already started putting on a toaster, a long time ago. But so that you might not be able to point at something and go, that's a computer, because there'll be computer chips and everything. So it's just completely integrated and invisible, like maybe in your own brain.
This is Bubba. Here I am. I'm standing here with John Roman from Miro Computer Products, and he's got a digital capture board that will actually capture your video off of your camera and put it into the computer so that you can edit it. Once you're finished editing the computer on the computer, then you can output it to your VHS tape or Super VHS tape. Now, we don't want to knock the other products, because some of these other products are real good. We do know that this one is somewhat less expensive than some of the other ones.
Yes, it is. We've kept this, tried to make it affordable for consumer videographers. We use, as I said earlier, all aircraft-grade parts. We get these from the same places that supply the top indie car teams and so forth. Our unit folds completely flat.
So did you use any of the cars like that crashed this past weekend to make any of your new ones?
No, we weren't involved in that, but we use the same type parts that go into.
So for everybody that's got like a jiggling hand, this will help you out if you're doing handheld stuff?
It does help you out a lot, and also you have a much wider range of motion. motion. Rather than having the camera on your shoulder or even in your hands, with this device you can come and you can move it all around.
Well, can you still get that MTV kind of feel where it's all sideways and everything with this, or is it going to make it so steady that it doesn't look that way?
You can still get the look if you want. See, here you have full control just like with some of the other products. Of course, you don't have
I'm getting seasick. I think I'm going to throw up. This is Bubba. Here I am. I'm standing here with John Roman from Miro Computer Products, and he's got a digital capture board that will actually capture your video off of your camera and put it into the computer so that you can edit it. Once you're finished editing the computer, then you can output it to your VHS tape or Super VHS tape. I wanted to ask John, who's an expert in nonlinear editing. John, what is nonlinear editing?
Nonlinear editing is the ability to take analog video and digitize it on your computer.
Hey, what are you looking at, Cochelle? What are you looking at, buddy?
Or on your PCI Power Mac computer. So you can take our same card and put it either in a PC or a PCI Power Mac. Take the video, take the analog video, and then digitize it. Then that allows you to edit that video with Adobe Premiere software that we bundle with the product.
Now, by digitize, you mean turn it into zeros and ones?
Exactly.
Now, what is analog then? It's just pictures of the video on the tape, or what?
Analog is the video that you currently get today with your video camera. There are digital video cameras that are coming out that automatically digitize the video, such as the new Sony video cameras. They're more expensive than the regular cameras today, but they're on their way.
So why do they call it non-linear editing as opposed to linear editing?
Well, with non-linear editing, you're able to take the video clips that you've stored on your computer and move them around much easier. You can add titles and transitions anywhere you want on a timeline with the Adobe Premiere software.
So you could kind of start wherever you wanted to automatically. Instead of with a tape, you have to go in and fast-forward the tape to wherever you want it to go to and start there, but with nonlinear editing, since it's just a file on a disk, you can say start at 1/4 of the way through the file or 30 seconds into the file, and it'll instantly start there. You don't have to fast forward or rewind.
That's right. It's all on your computer. The video that you've captured on your computer can be manipulated and moved around very, very easily.
So what are the steps of doing nonlinear editing? I mean, I imagine there has to be some way of getting it from the camera to the machine and then from the machine back to your tape again.
Sure.
How do you do that?
You simply plug in your camera to the Miro Video DC20. The camera, the software from Adobe allows you to capture the video that is being played off of your camera. Miro will compress the video onto the computer, and then Adobe Premiere will allow you to edit the software, add special effects, and then we decompress the video right out to your VCR tape.
So it sounds pretty simple to me.
Actually, it's very simple. You capture, you edit, and you output.
Hey, we're with John Cochelle again, who's been following us around on this whole shoot here today. And John has a couple of questions because he's an actual interested party looking to buy this for his own use. John, go ahead.
How much computer do I need to be able to run something like this?
On the PC, we're recommending a Pentium type of processor along with, say, a 1 or 2 gig hard drive that's dedicated towards storing video.
And how much video can I store? How much video can I store on 2 gigs?
That's going to depend on the compression ratio that you've set for the video quality that you want output. But on general, as a general, you'd want to probably allow for 100 megabytes a minute.
100 megabytes a minute. Give me another way of translating 100 megabytes a minute. Oh, 100 megabytes a minute. So if I have 2 gigs, how many minutes can I store there?
Well, that'd be about 20 minutes of video.
Now that's from John Cochelle asking that intelligent question is, how do you divide 2 gigabytes by 100 megabytes?
I did it.
John, that's a 20, I'd say to you.
I did it.
Can you tell me something else? What do you recommend for a PC to run your software on?
A minimum system today would be maybe a Pentium 90 megahertz, about 16 megabytes of memory, and maybe a 2 gigabyte hard drive as a minimum configuration. Anything above that would greatly help a user because they would need a significant amount more memory, maybe 24 or 32 megabytes to really speed up things a little. But as a minimum base configuration, a 90 megahertz, 16 megabytes, and a 2 gigabyte hard drive would be about it.
So tell us something, John, about what your product does, the Miro product. I see all these big, bright awards you've won. Tell us something about what is your product and what does it do and how does it relate to everything?
Well, the reason for the awards is because Miro has been able to bring the cost of doing nonlinear digital video editing down from $5,000, which was the previous price that someone getting into nonlinear editing had to pay as a minimum. We brought that price down to under $1,000. And so that kind of price breakthrough is something that a lot of the editors that are reviewing the product are noticing, and they see a value there to the end user.
Well, you could bring the price down, but then the quality could suffer. What have you done about that?
Well, with the quality, we have been able to do what these $5,000 boards have been able to do in the past, because we have developed our own ASICs, what they call ASICs, on the board that allow you to focus on the fantastic output that you're going to get with the Miro.
Mookie Blaylock wears ASICs to play basketball, doesn't he?
You've probably had to answer a lot of times. It's in the press a lot. When your board captures, I know it just captures the video. Now you have to capture the audio separately, so you need an audio card to go with the video card, and you need a special audio card that costs a couple hundred dollars, I imagine. But in the press lately, they've been talking about how you have a problem syncing up the sound with the video. In other words, when the guy moves his voice, it doesn't sound like we are going to go. So tell us what you've done and how that works, and if there is a problem there, just give us an inside scoop on that.
Miro focused on the video quality for the Miro Video DC20 and is relying on the customer's already existing sound card. If you're going out and getting a sound card, we recommend a DSP-based sound card that will offload the processing from the Pentium computer chip to the DSP sound card. Adobe Premiere 4.0 is what we currently ship with the product. There was an audio-video sync type of problem with the 4.0. They've recently come out with version 4.2 and have corrected that problem. So that problem doesn't exist in the latest version of 4.2 Adobe Premiere software.
So you've gotten it together. Now, I see John over here really wants to ask a question. Go.
You mentioned two products that you need to do this process, Miro and Adobe Premiere. Do they come together? Are they sold separately? Or?
The Miro Video DC20 comes with the hardware, of course, and we bundle the Premiere and Photoshop LE software along with Asymmetrix 3D FX for 3D titling and animation.
So you get the board and, I feel like I'm doing a commercial where you get all these things, you get all this in for $1,000?
For $999 suggested list, but...
The board and the software, Adobe Premiere and the...
Now, I need to say something here because Bubba knows a lot about all these different companies, but there are probably right now about 15 or 20 people who are selling boards and software for under $1,000 that have something called 60 field, 30 frames per second capture ratio rates. However, and there's probably another 50 people who are trying to bring out one. Can you tell us something about what you've got here?
Yeah, I work for a computer company called Adobe, and Adobe makes a video editing piece of software called Premiere. And with Premiere, it is actually the software that allows you to capture the video into your computer and then do the editing, something you would normally do with the video tape systems that most people around here are selling today.
Now, everybody always says Adobe, Adobe, Adobe Premiere for whenever they're doing digital editing. Why is that?
Adobe has been a leader in the graphics domain since 1983. Adobe was the company that invented PostScript and applications like
Adobe, Adobe, Adobe Premiere, Adobe, Adobe, Adobe Premiere.
Graphic artists. So it was a natural for us to come up with an application that allows you to do digital video editing because it is really an extension of the standard graphics environment.
Well, we're going to talk about the AV Master, the consumer home product, right now. We're going to come over here. I guess this is a demonstration running, and any of you who are faint of heart, don't look at this. These people are swimming around in here barely clothed.
Okay, AV Master is a brand new product from us. It's a PCI capture card, runs on any Pentium or a 46 with a PCI version 2 bus. It allows you to do audio on board, for one thing. So now you've eliminated all the sync problems that are traditionally associated syncing audio and video on the IBM PC platform. It'll do compression as low as 4:1, which is unheard of at the price performance point we have at $1,100. And it's PCI plug and play, and it's PCI bus master, and all these good computer terms that mean high performance and high quality. So what you're seeing here is an $1,100 product, retail price, that's able to do compression quality that's better than the DV stuff you've been looking at, that is totally indistinguishable from the original material. And use Adobe Premiere or ULEAD Media Studio or Star Media or Razer or any of these editing packages to edit with it. It's full Microsoft AVI compatible, so you can integrate it into your presentations or anything you want to do.
There's a Bravado 1000, a Targa 1000, and a Targa 2000. Could you tell me what the differences are?
Boy, you know more than I do so far. Actually,
I'm just reading the brochures right there.
Okay. Yes. The difference is there's actually many differences, and they're somewhat of a technical nature. But in the most basic sense, the Bravada 1000 card that is actually running this computer here, you have less quality in the video that you're capturing into your computer.
Hi, Dennis. Good to see you again.
I guess it's also less cost. It's around $1,000, I believe.
That's correct. The Targa 1000 is about $3,200. The Bravado card is about $1,000. And then there is a Targa 2000, which is the top-of-the-line system that not only gives you the basic video capture capability, but also audio capture capability, as well as a very clean image in terms of the video quality, like I said.
Good job. Again, walking around the show a little bit, I think he's got about 3 or 4 pounds in the bag, so you can tell how long he's been here with the 3 or 4 pounds in the bag. But John, what are your opinion of the show right now?
You know, as I said earlier, there's a wide variety of products, and there are some really interesting ones. I'm particularly interested in the product.
Okay, that's really good. We're glad to hear that. So if I got one of these capture cards, and then I got your Adobe Premiere and Adobe Effects, I could make that video?
Well, there's of course one piece we need to add, and that is of course skill, and I'm not sure if you would have that, but if you do, then you could, yes.
Well, you know who you're talking to. You're talking to Bubba here.
Well, I forgot Bubba. I'm sorry about that.
Now, Bubba doesn't need skill. Bubba just has a lot of heart, and he goes out and just does it blindly. He doesn't care if he's got skill. If it's ugly, that's good, because that's Bubba's ugly.
Just heart and soul. Put it right in there, and off you go.
So now digital video is kind of following the path that digital audio took a couple of years ago. It allows you to record the original signal in a digital form. It's no longer got to go straight to analog, then to digital. It'll go straight to digital. Extremely high quality. You have no generation loss. When you make a copy of a copy of a copy of a videotape, what do you get? Mud. You get a terrible looking copy of a copy of a copy.
And butter when it starts spreading.
But when you make a copy of a copy of a copy of a floppy disk, the 10th level copy of the floppy disk works just as well as the first. There's no degradation, no signal loss. That's what digital video is like.
This will be first generation original to the customer, and he can have up to 16. These are VCR outputs. We run out of the mixer an S-video connection. The S-video connection goes into here, and you got 8 plus 8 stereo outputs, 8 more videos, and 8 more stereo.
Count them for me, baby. Count them.
VCR is hooked up to this thing, and we're going to create the tape on the fly. So this tape will become instantaneously a fully edited video mix, audio mix, characters, time code, the credits, the titles, everything, all music backgrounds. Everything is done. When the speaker steps off the stage, you take your finger, and instead of hitting rewind, that's 3 minutes, hit eject, slap the tape inside here, run up to the stage, and before he hits the last step, you got your 4, 5, 6, or 16 tapes all done, edited. Now you go to Acapulco.
Because you got to get out of town fast because they're chasing you. Now, can I ask you, how many of these have the federal government ordered?
Believe it or not, they're in the hundreds. Believe it or not, they're with people like the FBI and the IRS, but they need portability and things, need things that are small and operated by one person. The Academy just ordered it today. The Air Force Academy ordered 6. But I don't sell them. They have to go and pick these up themselves.
They have to find them. Do you leave them in train stations for them? Or?
No, what they do is simply have to get the piece of paper that I'm handing out to everybody, and with this piece of paper, they're on their own. The story about me is on one side, and why I'm not selling, and why I don't want to sell them.